For anyone who's passionate about wildlife and desired to do wildlife photography, the first question which comes to mind is how to start wildlife photography. You will be filled with passion and interest on wildlife photography, but absolutely clueless in terms of where to start. How about we discuss on each and every step you need to take towards becoming a wildlife photographer. Hello everyone, welcome to Wild Photography. I am Alvis Lazarus. In this video, I am going to explain the key steps involved in starting your wildlife photography journey. So let's get it started. The first step you need to take is to decide the category of wildlife photography. You may even think, I have already decided to do wildlife photography. Why I need to decide the category? But even within wildlife photography, there are multiple categories of photography. To name few, photography of mammals, macro photography, bird photography, etc. There is nothing wrong in doing all of them. But the reason why I want you to choose a category to start with is the camera and lens requirement for each of this category of wildlife photography is very different. So to ensure you buy your first kit which suits you the best, it is very much needed that you decide the category you want to start with. So within the wildlife photography, if you are not still clear where your real passion lies, I would suggest you to accompany some of the existing wildlife photographers in your network and shadow them on field. Also, spend some time in the internet browsing through the work of different photographers in these category of wildlife photography. So by the end of this step, you would have decided in which category of photography you are going to start your wildlife journey, and then you move to the next step. I highly recommend that you start with a category of wildlife photography you like the most, master it, and then you can definitely try the other categories as well. So let's get on to step number two. In step number two, you need to learn the basics of wildlife photography. This learning is not specific to any category within wildlife photography, but an overall understanding of nuances in wildlife photography and wildlife photography equipment. Please keep in mind, the more time you spend on this step, the more you are delaying yourself to get onto the field. So the point here is you should learn the basics alone pretty fast, that is say within a maximum of 1 to 2 weeks. Learn the rest on the run and it is very much possible. So by the end of this step, you will know about cameras, camera modes, ISO, shutter speed, aperture, exposure, metering, focus points, and other key things within wildlife photography. This is what I will be teaching you in the channel in the coming weeks. So step number three, it's time to buy your camera and lens. This is a key milestone in your wildlife journey, and getting your first wildlife camera is a memory which you will cherish for your entire life. So to make this a good memory for you, you need to do a lot of research on the camera and lens before you invest your hard-earned money on it. So once you narrow down the top 3 or 5 different cameras and lenses which would suit you, you can even reach out to the other wildlife photographers who are doing photography for years for a second opinion. But my one single recommendation is just rent it for a few days and try it yourself before investing that kind of money. And I also recommend you to buy camera and lens only through authorized offline retailers of the brand. Step number four. Now that you got your first camera and lens, it is time you have an ice-breaking session with your camera and lens. I'm sure you know what is an ice-breaking session. It is a session followed in organizations for the people who join their organizations new to get to know each other. Unfortunately, since your camera and lens cannot talk with you, the only way you can have an ice-breaking session with your kit is by reading the manual. It is very important you go through the manual completely. While you go through your manual, if you couldn't understand the terms in the manual, I am really sorry, you have to go back to step number two and learn the basics again. And your mentor is equally responsible for this rework. Just kidding. So unless you know your camera well, you can never execute wildlife photography as you wish in your mind. So now step number 5, the first date with your camera. It is a very special day, the first day with your camera on the field. Leaving your brand new camera and lens more than a day at home is a sin. Ensure the first day you get to know about your camera and the second day you are on the field with your camera. My recommended location for your first date with your camera is your backyard or a nearby lake or a zoo which is nearby. The reason why I am suggesting to go to these places is they don't cost you much and you can spend the time you want without any rush. Please don't expect by day one on the field you will get all the desired output as you wish. Things may not work exactly the way you have expected. You may end up having more questions on wildlife photography. You may even feel your first camera is not good enough. But you have to keep yourself motivated and complete the full day on field taking hundreds of images and return home with hundreds of questions. That's fine. The next few days, you will have to find answers to all those questions by referring back to the basics or by talking to your mentor. You have to keep repeating this step for every day for at least 10 to 15 days on field. Now that you are having a good hands-on at your camera, the step number 6 is learning the basics of post-processing. So first you need to decide which software or tool you are going to use for post-processing your images. Equal to knowing how to take an image, it is important that you know how to post-process your image as well. Trust me here, learning post-processing is not that tough as it is being projected. It is much easier than working on your cell phone. Part of this basics of post-processing, you should learn all the different parameters which you can control in a post-processing workflow. And it is very important if you plan to participate in competitions, you should know the post-processing workflow which is accepted by most of the competitions. I'll be also sharing post-processing workflow as well as post-processing mobile apps in the channel in the coming weeks. Step number 7. It's time you make your social presence, so you need to set up all your social handles. Though it is absolutely optional to have a social presence, I would recommend to have a social profile where you can showcase your wildlife work. There are many platforms available, but I would suggest you can limit yourself to a maximum of 3 to 4 platforms unless you are doing it commercially. Ensure that you spend more time on the field doing wildlife photography and not on social media. This is my suggestion to all of you. Next up, it's time to complete your full kit. You should now buy all the accessories which would complete your wildlife photography kit. This would include tripod, monopod, camera rest, covers, raincoat, cleaning kit, weather protector, camera bag, lens cap, memory card, etc. Any questions on this, please post to me in the comment section. I would be glad to give more information on that. Your kit is ready and you are also ready. It is now time to make a travel plan for your first wildlife travel. Again, you may get into a roadblock. Where to go? Which is a good place? Who's the best naturalist? How much it will cost me? What and all I should take with me? How to plan my safari? Which zones are good? Which is the right time to visit? Now you need to find answers to all these questions part of your travel plan. There are hundreds of wildlife destinations you can visit for wildlife photography, and it is impossible for me to cover everything here. But if you have a specific question on a destination, you can post on the comment section. I am also planning to do a specific video on how to do a budget travel. You won't believe the price in which actually you can do wildlife photography. And for now, you need to do a search on Google and also talk with a lot of people to finalize your itinerary for your first wildlife travel. And step number 10, it's time now you get on to field and kickstart your wildlife journey. What an exciting time. You are on your first wildlife trip. This is the time you need to put in all what you have learned till now in action. Please keep in mind, none of the moments you encounter in the wild will repeat itself. So this is the time all your skills will be tested. Initially, you may have to remember each and every step and execute to capture a beautiful wildlife moment. It could be a little tough remembering all the settings you need to do for every moment. But as you keep doing this again and again, you will develop your muscle memory. So what that means is, you will start working like a machine on the field, doing the ISO changes, aperture changes, doing the exposure controls, everything quite dynamically. So you would start doing wildlife photography at ease, and that's the reason you have to be on field at least once every month. So welcome on board. Share, network and learn. You are a wildlife photographer now. Looking forward to meet you someday on the field. Thank you so much and all the very best to you.